Happy Monday, everybody. Modest gains here for the markets. The Dow's being weighed down by Boeing and 3M. But take a look at the sectors. And again, you like to see the sector leadership with bank stocks leading, semiconductors. Emerging markets are just doing fantastic. I mean, China's sitting at a nine-month high there. Metals and mining, they're all up. Vale halt of production at an iron ore mine, and that's fearing some concerns about a supply crunch, so the metal stocks are up. But industrials are flat right now, and they're being weighed down by Boeing and 3M, and the airlines also a little bit on the weak side, but they just turned positive as well. So let's look at where we are. We've been circling, we've been doing all these little circles for the last week or so, but we broke through the 2815 level on the S&P 500, and that's the key level. There's 2820 that we broke through. That was on Friday, big breakout there. The VIX, lowest level since October. We had a 12 handle, believe it or not, back on Friday, but it's over 13 right now. So we put up the VIX here, lowest level since October. That's an important breakthrough there. We saw that there. Then we also had the bond yields. We're sitting near the new lows for the year. The new high list has been littered with utilities, for example. Also right near new high, or REITs have been having many stocks there at 52-week highs right now. There's your utilities moving to the upside. So the question is, what could keep the rally going at this point? And obviously, global central banks have been accommodative from China to Japan to the ECB to the Federal Reserve. We have generally declining inflation fears. There are still some recession fears out there, but they have been quieter recently as well. China's in full-on stimulus mode right across the board, including lowering taxes there. Europe is at six-month highs on some hopes that the crummy economic data we've seen might finally be bottoming. That's a pretty long-term hope right now, but at least we have seen Europe outperform the United States this month. And of course, the most important thing is earnings. The downward earnings revisions we've been seeing for 4 or 5 or 6 months has essentially come to a halt. It's still down, but it's not dropping. So remember, for the first quarter on January 1st, we were expecting 5% earnings growth, and they just cut it to pieces in the next 6 weeks. By February 15th, we were negative. Today, we're still negative, but the rate of decline has basically stopped. Last week, we sort of stopped declining. We'll see if we can move positive in the next several weeks on that. The ones you want to watch this week are Micron and FedEx. So Micron, of course, big drops in their earnings last quarter because of the concerns about China. They get 60% of their revenues from China, as well as intense competition. FedEx, of course, concerns about slowing in the international shipping business there. We'll get some comments from them. Finally, I know everybody's very excited about the Lyft IPO, but we've got another really big famous name coming to the New York Stock Exchange. Levi Strauss is coming here. This is the world's largest denim apparel brand. They're supposed to price Wednesday night for trading here on Thursday. We'll keep an eye on them, and there's going to be a lot of people wearing denim. They came here a few weeks ago and basically gave out denim on the floor, so you're going to get a lot of people wearing that denim on Friday, and that'll be one of the big names that we've seen in the first quarter. Right now, the Dow's down, but S&P's up 5 points.
Somehow I missed that, the denim handout. Bob, thank you.
Big, they were all on the floor for all day and had literally an entire warehouse of denim here that people were picking and
Good
choosing.
Good thing I have some of my own in the collection.